Hi everyone, welcome to another Sunday class. Today we're going to talk about the first part of the armor of God, which is the belt, but not any belt, the belt of truth. Let's think first about our daily lives. What happens if you don't wear a belt? Can your pants slide down? They do, right? That's why wearing a belt is so important even nowadays. Now, let's think about a Roman soldier back then. When you think of their armor, what comes to your mind first? Maybe for most of us, it's not necessarily the belt. Maybe we think about the helmet or about the sword. We think about the arms and legs all covered in metal. But if you read in the Bible, in Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 to 18, you can see that the first thing that is mentioned is not any of those things. It is actually the belt. And in this case, it is the belt of truth. So Roman soldiers used to wear belts just like the ones in these pictures, and the belt was the most important part of the armor. Why? Because the belt keeps everything together. The belt keeps the whole armor together. That's why it is the most important part, or one of the most important parts of the armor. It also helps take some weight off the shoulders. Now, when we think about the armor of God, it includes the belt of truth. Truth can be found in the Word of God, the Bible. This is so important because the truth can save us from so many uncomfortable moments, and knowing God's truth can help us avoid the embarrassment of sin. It helps us know right from wrong, as the Bible teaches, and can keep us in the right path. Knowing the truth guides us to follow Jesus and to make wise choices in all situations. Now, I would like you to think of the world that we are living right now. If you think about it, they are calling bad to what is good, and good to what is bad. So we have to be very, very careful with everything we see, everything we hear, everything people tell us, because even though some people might think it's the right thing to do, the Bible will tell us otherwise, and we should always trust and follow the Bible, since that is the one and only truth. So let's just be very careful about the things we watch on TV, the things we see on social media, the music we listen to. We have to be very, very careful, because even though everybody around us might be saying one thing, the Bible tells us different. The Bible tells us what is good. The Bible guides us closer and closer to God. That is the whole purpose of the Bible. One of the characteristics of our God is that He is a God of truth. He cannot lie. So we can trust that whatever He says, it is true. And Jesus also said that He is the truth. That is why we need to read and study God's Word, the Bible, so that we can know what the truth is. And we can spot the lies and recognize when someone is telling us something that is not true. We need to always compare what we learn to what the Bible says. In the Bible, God tells us about many things, including history, science, and morals. So whenever the Bible touches on a topic, we need to believe it and accept it and use it as our standard of truth. As members of God's kingdom, we need to make sure that we put on truth. The Lord wants us to be truthful inside and out. We are to tell the truth and speak truthfully with everyone. And we need to know the difference between truth and error. right and wrong in whatever we hear or read or watch. The Bible tells us in John chapter 8 verse 44 that the devil is the father of lies. The Bible says in this verse that he was a murderer from the beginning, not holding to the truth, for there is no truth in him. When he lies, he speaks his native language, for he is a liar and a father of lies. That means that any lie that comes around in the world comes straight from Satan himself. He's always trying to twist God's word and trying to make us think that God said something that he didn't actually say. The devil is trying to confuse us and he wants us to believe his lies. Let's watch this short video about the story of Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. In this story, the devil presents himself as a friendly, nice snake, and he is trying to get Adam and Eve to disobey God with lies. He's lying to them and telling them things that God never said. That's what the devil does even nowadays. So let's look at this video and let's think about how much we need the word of God and his truth.
Even though you can't see it, there's a spiritual battle taking place between God and the devil over the hearts of each person on earth. Since the beginning of time, God has been fighting for people to know who he is and how much he loves them. When God created the world we live in, there were two people named Adam and Eve. They lived in the Garden of Eden, and they were friends with God. God gave Adam and Eve everything they needed and told them that they could eat anything growing in the garden except for the food growing on one tree, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. God warned Adam and Eve that if they did eat from that tree, they would die. The Bible tells us that Adam and Eve had a very real enemy who wanted to twist that truth into a major lie. Their enemy was the devil, and because the devil can take on many forms, he came as a sneaky, sneaky snake. The snake came to Eve and asked her what God said about the fruit in the garden. Eve told him that God said if she ate from the tree, she would die. But the snake convinced Eve that that was a lie. He said, "You won't die if you eat the fruit. You'll know things that you've never known before." Eve listened to the snake's lie and got distracted from the truth. Not only did Eve eat a piece of fruit, she also gave some to Adam. Right away, they realized they had done something wrong. God punished them because of what they had done and made them leave the garden where they had been living. Adam and Eve chose to believe the lie that the devil told them over the truth that God had for them. At that moment, evil and death entered the world, and we're still battling them today. When we remember God's word, we put on the belt of truth. It is the part of God's armor that gives us the power to stand up against the lies that come our way. So when we hear things like, "No one loves you," or "You'll never be enough," we can know those are lies. God loves us, and because of that, he's given us all the tools we need to fight the enemy and win. With the belt of truth, we'll be able to detect lies and overcome them with God's powerful truth. We can put on the belt of truth.